In the last video, we met Michelle, who manages the customer feedback workflow at Phoenix Corp. We watched Michelle identify the starting and ending points of her workflow and map the steps between. If you missed that video, we recommend checking it out first, then coming back. In this video, you'll learn best practices for setting up the foundation of your workflow in Asana and see how Michelle uses them to build hers. So, where should you start? To answer that question, let's review Asana's hierarchy. Projects, tasks, and subtasks are the building blocks of your workflows. Let's look at some key decisions to consider as you use these elements to build the foundation of your workflow. We recommend starting with a project to house your overall workflow. The tasks or subtasks that will be completed between the start and finish of the workflow should be actionable and bite-sized. Tasks that are too vague, like promotion, or too big, like promote the event, are difficult to execute. Instead, break work down into bite-sized pieces. Let's go back to Michelle. She'll start by creating a project for the feedback workflow. Each task in the project represents an individual piece of feedback that needs to be actioned. When deciding how to use project sections, it's helpful to understand the two main ways that work moves through a workflow: in sequences and stages. Sequences are like checklists. Work gets completed in a specific order, building up to a final deliverable. Planning an event or onboarding a new hire are great examples of sequenced workflows. In these cases, use sections to group tasks by category or timeframe. Stages are like pipelines. A single piece of work or deliverable moves through a series of stages to completion. Request processes or product development pipelines are great examples of staged workflows. In these cases, use sections to represent each stage. Michelle recognizes that each piece of feedback she receives moves through the same set of stages to be resolved: intake, processing, and resolution. She adds section headers for each of those stages. Custom fields let you categorize tasks, so you can sort and automate your workflow based on those categories. You should think about custom fields early. The way you organize, automate, and report on your workflow depends on which fields you've added. Michelle already categorizes feedback in her spreadsheet in order to know which stakeholders work on that request. So she creates a field called feedback type. Sometimes a single task or deliverable needs to be broken out into smaller sequential steps. If the top-level task is a request, consider using subtasks to capture the follow-up steps. In Michelle's case, a sequence of actions need to be taken for each piece of feedback as it moves through the stages of her workflow. So she adds subtasks to the main piece of feedback to capture those steps. Once you've built your foundation, you're ready to add customizations and automations to get your work flowing smoothly from start to finish. You'll learn how to do that in the next video.